Parsons to tap it in. And we have a tie game here in the third. Big collision at center ice as McCabe.
Yeah, Laine. This is scary. This game could go one way. Patrick Laine just got absolutely laid out. And this is scary to see.
Jake McCabe has gone straight to the Vancouver or the Buffalo dressing room. Patrick Laine getting attention on the ice.
Well, this is obvious with Patrick Laine. I think he was right out on this play. And I'm not sure where the puck is. We'll take a look. Puck, and the puck is there. In a bad spot. As McCabe steps up and I'm not sure if it's when he falls back in his head. You can see Patrick Laine. And I think his head hits the ice, and that's maybe more the damage. Good sign is he's able to get up. And he needs to be helped off. This is unfortunate for a young superstar now who is going to be out of the lineup. Wow. We'll see what the call is here, and more importantly, how the reaction for the Winnipeg Jets will be moving forward.
Well, for six games, we've talked about this, how for six games, Paul Maurice has been able to run the same lines. And you have to think that that might change now with the injury there to Patrick Laine.
You don't see those big hits anymore. Mark Scheifele is going to get a roughing call.
And that may be the only penalty.
Yeah. The puck was right there as a vulnerable position. And I'm not sure McCabe leaves his feet for the hit, but the puck was either wasn't a late hit. It happened so quickly as McCabe stepped up. There's a count. There's the puck. And there's McCabe. He's already committed to the hit. And then Scheifele comes in right away. Everyone gets involved. Power play here for the Buffalo Sabres.
Jake McCabe went straight back to the Buffalo dressing room. So we'll keep an eye whether he returns, whether he got injured somewhere in the incident with Scheifele, or whether he got injured on the initial hit. But it's another power play here for the Buffalo Sabres, who have scored 2:26 seconds apart.